Good morning, everybody. Today is April 22nd, 2022. Weather outside here in Southern California is slightly overcast. It's kind of cloudy, high 50s as it were right now, but that's okay. That still means it's some pretty good weather out here. It's about 10 a.m. Hope you guys are ready for another establishment of Autodesk Virtual Academy. Woo, yay! Joining us here today, we have Thomas Stuhel. I hope I didn't butcher that last name, but thanks for coming on as another guest presenter here, Thomas. Very happy to have you back. Thomas is a senior
Thank
technical
you.
support specialist at Autodesk. He actually hails from Germany, is that right? Well, I was curious what the weather's like there right now.
Yeah, I mean, when I look outside, I don't see clouds, but we go right into the sundown. So yeah,
I see.
it looks good.
Yeah, Thomas is actually joining us from Germany right now, so it's a much appreciated. The sun truly never sets on the kingdom of Autodesk. So, regardless, hopefully it's still some perfect weather there for another What's New in AutoCAD 2022 over there. With that, I'm going to hand it off to you, man, if you'd like to say a bit more about yourself and let us know what we're talking about here today, man.
Okay, yeah. Welcome everybody to the presentation of what's new in AutoCAD 22. My name is Thomas. I work as a senior technical support specialist for Autodesk since 5 years, and I'm very excited to share with you today what's new in the new release of AutoCAD 22. Yeah, we have some new, really handy functionality. And when it comes to the presentation, I will try not to jump so much between the slide deck and the running AutoCAD application, and that's why I will bundle a few things together. The session will give you an overview up front in form of some slides, followed by a live demonstration afterwards. And just feel free in between. Adam in the background will answer. Sorry for my cough. It sounds worse than it is actually. So we will start with the presentation, but at the beginning, we are curious about some questions. Adam will run some poll questions.
Just a quick reminder too, this is a Zoom webinar, and so if you guys do need to ask questions, there is a Q&A section, should be in your action toolbar, and also a chat menu as well if you want to communicate over chat. I'm about to launch a poll right now where you can see it should pop up on your screen right now. That's just to get a better idea of who's in the audience here today so it could cater the conversation a bit better. We're kind of curious, one, what type of specialized tool sets are you using? And two, where do you use AutoCAD most of the time? In the office, in the field, mix of both perhaps, who knows? That should show up on the window right there. See what you got. Do have quite a lot of mechanical. Wow, like a majority mechanical. All right on. Okay. Yeah. And so for Thomas, yeah, it looks like we're looking at pretty large majority of AutoCAD mechanical users, actually. It's almost 70% mechanical users, it seems like, on here. But a good mix of architectural, electrical, plant 3D, MEP, and raster design as well. And then most people are using AutoCAD in the office as well. But there's a good portion of people also using a mix of both right now. Appreciate it. Thanks for the info, guys. I'm going to hand it back here to Thomas. When you're ready, man.
Yes, I am. Let's move forward. So here's an overview of what we will cover a little bit more in detail. Yeah, today we are covering three key components of the new 22 release. First, CAD automations. Yeah, what's meant by CAD automations? I will share quickly how the specialized tool sets speed up work by automating tasks. A second point, what is meant by seamless collections? I will quickly talk about the web and the mobile app that allow you to connect to drawing files anywhere from any device. And I think it's also good as an introduction because they will give you a better understanding of some of our continuous innovations and multi-platform workflows that we present in the third part, which is why you're here, the continuous innovations, which means the new updates of the version 22. So let's start with point number one. What's meant by CAD automation is actually anything that helps you with automations in the background to work faster and to work more efficient. That can be related to a single function where you are faster and more efficient. But in this case, and where the CAD automations are most effective, is within the AutoCAD tool sets. And we will have a closer look at it now. I know that a large majority of you is using the tool sets already, but I know that there are also some users out there on YouTube, for example. And in order to cover those which might also use more plain AutoCAD we focus also in explaining the specialized tool sets. It's actually all about the right AutoCAD for you. We see them on the left side, MEP, electrical, architecture, mechanical, plant 3D, map 3D, and raster design. Over the past 20 years, AutoCAD has been investing or Autodesk in the vertical specialized toolset. They make you more productive because they come with enhanced industry-specific functionality. And since release 2020, every subscriber of AutoCAD gains access to all the capabilities of the industry-specific toolsets and libraries. And it got introduced at that time as one AutoCAD. So how does the situation look on your side? I know some of you are using the toolsets already, but maybe some of you just use Core AutoCAD even though you work in a specific field which is covered by one of the verticals. Maybe because you just started using AutoCAD or because of the force of habit since you always worked like that. So I would like to give you a rough overview of which options you have with the industry-specific toolsets and what that could mean for you. Yeah, we see here the boat on the right side. Have you ever wanted to create floor plans, interior ventilation, circuits of a building or boat? Of course, you can do that with Core AutoCAD and draw the whole building or boat just with single lines and blocks. But I'm telling you, and you probably know this already, that's a lot of effort and you should ask yourself, why doing all this effort and if you can be more efficient? Why not taking the advantage of MEP, architecture, electrical, and mechanical, which add thousands of intelligent industry-specific objects, styles, and features to your application? Because with these verticals, you will always have the right tools at hand. And the best thing is, you can keep on working in a familiar AutoCAD interface. So it's not only the right AutoCAD for you, as I said at the beginning, it's actually the right AutoCAD for the job that needs to be done. And I would like to show you on the next slides which benefits these CAD automations bring to you and your company, because we ask our customers which productivity gain they get when they use a specialized AutoCAD tool. And I would like to focus on the four examples that we had on the previous slide. Also, when you use them already, these numbers will be very interesting for you. Our customers, they describe that they get a 55% overall productivity gain when they work with a mechanical toolset instead of pure AutoCAD. With AutoCAD architecture, the customers describe that they get 61% productivity gain. With electrical toolsets, they describe that they even get a 95% overall productivity gain. That number and also the others are very impressive. And with MEP, you are 85% more productive. Imagine what could be accomplished by using these toolsets in your company for every draftsperson that works in the specific industry field. So just make your life easier. I mean, choose the right toolset. It's free anyways when you are a subscriber of AutoCAD. Or maybe you want to become one if you are currently using AutoCAD LT. So in general, if you don't use the toolsets yet, just give them a shot and you will see that you and your team have a big chance of working more effectively. Now the second point, seamless connections. You see on the left side, with a subscription of AutoCAD, you have access to AutoCAD Desktop, AutoCAD Web, and AutoCAD Mobile. Now that means you can choose, do I want to work with AutoCAD for Windows, AutoCAD for Mac, AutoCAD Web, or AutoCAD on a mobile device? Do I want to work with an iPad, an iPhone, Android, or Windows device? The nice thing is, you can even work with all of them. It's up to you. These apps enable you to work on any of your drawings on any platform when they are stored in the cloud. And that means you can create, edit, design, and draft actually anytime and anywhere. Now, other than that, access to all applications brings more benefits for you. For example, just forget printed drawings. You don't really need printed drawings anymore to show the information in the field or to forward information. Just take your portable device with you and show it in the field. Also, no need to go back to the office because you forgot the plans or you took the wrong ones or you lose important time for your project because you have to drive back. Also, for meetings, you can easily cut down communication time and bring design teams together to review and edit CAD drawings in real time wherever you are. Now, these apps, they go hand in hand. That means easily go from drafting on your desktop to drafting on your AutoCAD web and mobile apps and vice versa. And of course, wherever you go, you can have peace to have at least AutoCAD in your pocket when you don't forget your mobile phone at home. So just a quick overview now when it comes to the web and the mobile app. When you compare it to the desktop app, it looks similar, but it runs in the browser. You get Core AutoCAD 2D drafting tools and commands in a simplified interface. And that means also for you, you can quickly get up to speed and be productive with little to no training when you are used to AutoCAD already. You don't have to download anything. You don't have to install anything. Just simply visit web.autocad.com, sign in with your Autodesk account, and start working on the drawings stored in the cloud. And with version 22, you can mark up and share drawings directly in the app, and it's available in the same 14 languages as AutoCAD. And with the drawings saved in the cloud, all the work that you do in AutoCAD Web is accessible when you switch devices. Why should you switch devices? Maybe you go to a construction site right now, and the one device that you can use is a phone or as a tablet. And for these devices, we have the mobile app. The functionality compared to the web app is the same. It just looks a little bit different, which is kind of understandable since you use your hand to navigate and not your mouse. But it comes compared to the web app also with extra functionalities. For example, it lets you work anywhere, also offline. And it comes with mobile only tools. For example, you can add laser measurements to your drawings and also site photos to your plans. And one thing that they all have in common is cloud storage connectivity, where you can connect seamlessly across platforms.
And out of curiosity, Thomas, do you need a VPN or anything to use this sort of stuff?
No, you don't. You can connect from within the web app directly to the external cloud storage providers. There's an interface within the browser. You log in and you see all the folders, all the structures that you have within your Dropbox, for example, also within the interface of the web app. So there's no VPN, nothing that you need to set this one up.
Oh, fantastic. Right on.
Okay. So the cloud storage connectivity. Last year, we announced partnership with Google Drive. That means now, we have four of the biggest storage providers that you can add to AutoCAD. That is Box, that is Dropbox, that is OneDrive, and that is Google Drive. And the benefits, they are clear and visible. You have access to your most up-to-date version of the drawings from anywhere. And additionally to that, we have great news. There's also more value for active 22 subscribers, because this year we added the connection to Autodesk Drive and Autodesk Docs to the web app. And for those who haven't come across them yet, Autodesk Drive is available with all subscriptions. They both offer cloud storage, and Autodesk Docs is a cloud-based document management and common data environment, which is available for subscribers of the AC collections. And with these integrations, you can take advantage of anytime access to any drawing file with AutoCAD. And now we come to the third part. That's why you all hear the new features and enhancements of 22. And please keep in mind, those are also available for LT, which is on particular functions a really, really big win, but you will see that later. Let's start with a trace functionality. In general, trace is an exciting new multi-platform feature to streamline the review process and to enhance collaboration. You see that on the picture, that there's a light gray layer on the drawing. Just picture a very lightweight trace paper on top of your drawing, and it helps you to come up with an alternative markup design, and you can let people know, hey, this is kind of what I'm thinking, and I think this needs to be changed. And except of making changes on the physical drawing, you are drawing something on that very thin trace paper that you put on top of your drawing. And that means you and your collaborators, you can safely mark up drawing files without actually altering the existing drawing. And it allows you to open the traces back in AutoCAD because you create them in the web and in the mobile app. And when you open them back in AutoCAD, you can view the feedback in the context, and then you can incorporate the changes. Okay, the share function. Now with share, you have the ability to share your content quickly and very easily. Not just to your online storage locations that we mentioned earlier, but actually to anybody that you want. You can share the drawing, you can share the views, and it's a great function to enhance collaboration. How did you do that before? When you wanted to share a drawing with somebody, Before, you had to attach the drawing to an email. And when you sent that email out, you kind of lost control. It was forwarded to someone, and this person could forward it too. So you really lost control. And share is a function that allows you to share a link to somebody, and you can decide if that person can view only the drawing or can edit and save a copy. And that link that you sent is valid for 7 days. So you are in full control of that link. And they open directly in the web app. So you and your team and your colleagues can review and edit the drawing wherever they are. Both trace and share are multi-platform workflows, and they both make collaboration more accurate, more secure, and more efficient. Okay, the count function. It is actually a tool palette that opens, and it counts all the entities of your blocks in your drawing. Now, I know that that was a tricky thing in the past, especially for LT users, and now this function is also available for LT. What was done in the past, in AutoCAD, you had to run the bcount command, which was not available for LT. Even on bcount, you had limitations. For example, no nested blocks were shown. This time is over. You can also count the nested blocks in AutoCAD, and this function is also available for LT. It's a great new feature that actually saves you time with automation, and it also helps you finding errors in your drawing, which is a really, really helpful thing. And I'm happy to show this later. Okay, push to Autodesk Docs. As I said, Autodesk Docs is a unified cloud platform for the AEC industry, which is included in the AEC collection. You have a function to push your drawing file directly out to Autodesk Docs, to whatever subfolder or to whatever project you want, as a PDF file, not as a drawing, as a PDF file. That means you no longer have to save the PDF locally, open a web browser, and upload the sheets in the cloud. It is a one-step solution. And instead of taking 3 or 4 steps, you only have to take 1. So it improves efficiency and reduces steps and mistakes. Floating windows. We had a lot of requests in the past from customers, actually, who wanted a way to view and to edit multiple drawings at the same time in the same instance of AutoCAD. And that's basically what the function does. So you can take your CAD drawings and pull them out with drag and drop from the drawing tab, and then you can view them as a fully functional window. And that means you don't have to open several instances of AutoCAD on different windows when you work on several screens. Yeah, you can open them on different screens, but there's only one AutoCAD application running in the background. I know that that's a little bit tricky to show today since we only share one screen, but I think you will get a pretty good idea of how it's looking and what is actually possible. And other enhancements, AutoCAD has updated the installation and made it a little bit more customizable. Yeah, this will of course not be covered today since we already installed 22 before the presentation, but I can share not only the installation is much faster, you can already start the application while the program is still installing. And other than that, we have graphic improvements. There's a redesigned startup, which you will notice most. Yeah, it's more organized than before and more cleaned up. And we also have much faster PDF publishing in the background. Okay, and as a reminder again, all these functions are available for AutoCAD LT. And as an LT user, don't forget, you also have access to the web and to the mobile app. And I would like to show this to you now during the live demonstration. So I will stop the presentation right now. And here we go. Actually, one of the first changes you will notice is startup itself. Yeah, the startup itself is nothing new. It has been part of AutoCAD since many releases, but the overall composition of the startup has been redefined here quite a bit on the 22 release. And now it follows a consistent design across all Autodesk products. Now you can actually split it in 3 sections. The left side, the middle part, and the right side. And this is how we do this in the same order. I will give you a quick overview. We start in the upper left corner. Of course, you can open your drawings. you can directly navigate to the example drawings, for example, and you can just with a mouse click, of course, create a new drawing. Now, when you go to that list, you see the templates that you used before to create a new drawing. And when you browse to the templates and you select, for example, here a third one, it will also appear in your list. So you will always have a shortcut to the templates that you used last. Then we see three tabs: recent, Autodesk Docs, and learning. Recent, of course, as the name says, shows the recently last drawings. Yeah, here as a thumbnail with a small screenshot as a preview, you have the same functionality also in a list form. And when it comes to the functionalities within, you can pin it so that it always stays on top of your list. You can open it normal or read only. Let's say you are a CAD manager, you don't want to mess up the drawings of your team. That means you open it read only. And also nice, you can see with an icon directly if the drawing is saved locally on a server path or in the cloud. For example, here it's stored locally on my machine, whereas this one comes from Autodesk Docs. And that brings me here to Autodesk Docs. And here you have access to all your projects, all your accounts from within Autodesk Docs. There you see the drawings and you can quickly navigate, change the account to a different one, open the project, navigate through the folders, or go directly to where you were before. Project files, drawings, one of those is already open. It's here, the first one. And this is why we see here also the locked state. Yeah, that is a very, very helpful thing because this avoids that you and another colleague work on the same drawing at the same time. I know that some people try this with Box, with Dropbox. They log in with the same user, the same password, and then they work on the same drawings and then it gets synchronization issues. This can be avoided when you use Autodesk Cloud Solutions because they come with the lock state and it avoids that two people work on the same drawing at the same time. We have learning content, tips, videos, online resources, the Hitchhiker's Guide to AutoCAD, and free learning resources. LinkedIn Learning, lynda.com, CAD Learning, for example. In the lower left corner, there are online links that actually will open in your browser. There's what's new. The online help of version 22. If you have a technical issue, you can navigate to the community forum or open a case with a technical support. And what you can also do is you can navigate directly to the App Store or to the AutoCAD web app. Yeah. Now we managed the left side, we managed the middle part, but hey, the right side is missing. Why? Because it's only available when you activate the recent tab. And I recommend that you have it open from time to time because here will also be mentioned if there's a new update available for you in the current AutoCAD 22 version. You see other announcements, you see how you logged in the application, and you are also free to send us feedback for the application. Good. We see we covered everything here within the start tab, and now we move forward. Yeah, we have already few drawings open. The interface with the tabs is also with us since many releases, but since a few years, multiple monitors have become very popular and they have become part of everyday workflows from our side. And this is why I would like to show you the new extra functionality that we have here. Because as I said before, when we wanted to open several drawings on different monitors, we had to start an AutoCAD application for it. And that's not necessary anymore because you can really pull out that window. You see, you can put it back, it becomes blue, but you can pull it out of the ribbon. Yeah, you can resize it. You can move it around. You can even move it to a different screen, what I'm trying to show you right now. And it is fully functional. It's always connected to the ribbon. Yeah, and always connected to the command line, for example. But I recommend, in case you would, for example, move this one to a second screen, have, for example, the dynamic input active so that you can always work within that drawing. Yeah. Otherwise, you have to move your mouse from the ribbon and then to the other screen where the drawing is located. Or you do it like this. You always put your drawing where you're currently working on close to your ribbon and move another drawing to the second screen. And the benefit here of the floating window or the floating tab is that multiple drawings open in a single session of AutoCAD is typically a little bit better performing than multiple sessions of AutoCAD itself. Okay, now we come to the count function that I already introduced you before. And it hides here under view, there is the count command. And end users, they have been looking for that for quite a while. And it pretty much counts any selected objects or blocks in AutoCAD. Yeah, and when I open it, it comes with a list of all blocks within that drawing. Yeah, also nested blocks. You can compare it with the rename command. Yeah, also nested blocks listed. Yeah, but of course, with the rename command, you only get a list. What you get here on the left side is a live count of all objects from that block. Not only a list, but you can actually see where the objects are. In order to do that, for example, the FN phone, we have now 51 objects. I select the FN phone, and now all the objects become visible on my side. They become all green. And as I said, it's a live count. And that means when I go ahead and copy with CTRL C one object and paste it below, the number increases from 51 to 52 to 53. And the same way, of course, when I delete it, it goes down again. Not only that we see the list of objects or the list of blocks and that we see the live count, also in the middle, there is something that gets my attention and that are these warnings, these rectangles. We already have existing rectangles in this drawing, but I would like to show you, since we already selected the FN phone here, how we can create it ourselves, just that you get a feeling what can be, when could a warning like this appear? Yeah, we have now 52 FN phone blocks. When we go ahead, select this one and run and explode, it becomes red. And directly a warning appears here next to the FN phone. But it's not only a warning that tells us something is wrong. We know by the red sign which object has something wrong. And when we select the warning, it tells us there is an exploded block. Yeah, for us, that's very, very easy to roll back. We just have to undo it and go back to the list. Yeah, that scenario was created, but you can try that out with a floor plan example that is a standard drawing with AutoCAD. Just open it and you will get the same warning for the 36-inch door, because I select it now and we scroll out. There is one door that shows there's actually an issue. Yeah, and we select the warning and check what is the issue here. There's an overlapping object, and the tooltip tells us duplicate objects that overlap or are stacked on top of each other. Okay, let me double check. I select it. I open the properties. Yeah, I see two block references. I scroll down. They both have the same name. Really, they lay on top of each other. I select one, delete it, and now it becomes green again. The issue is solved. This is a standard drawing, and the issue is in the drawing not only since 1 month. Imagine how was it in the past. You as a company, you had a similar drawing and you wanted to give out the number of objects to another company. How long did it take you to find out that the number of doors is wrong? And once you found out that the number of doors is wrong, how long did it take you to find out why it was wrong or what is exactly wrong? And this function helps you with it. So the count function not only provides you the number of blocks, it also provides you with the functionality to solve issues in your drawing. And I'm telling you, in technical support, whenever I will get a drawing now from a customer, I will check with the count command if I can help the customer in other ways than only with the technical issue that he mentioned in his case, just to provide more help for the customer with account functionality. Okay, let's go back to the FN phone because we are not at the end. The count function has a lot of helpful things for us. Yeah, the FN phone is selected, and now I click my right mouse button and say in that count field. Yeah, it inserts now the number, the current number, 52. Yeah, that's also a live count. That means I can copy paste it. All I have to do is now a region, and it increases to 54. This 54 is an mText. That means I can also work on it. Yeah, I double click it and say the drawing contains 54 phones. Yeah, and this means you can add this information, these spoken information, in your drawing to make it understandable for other people. And you don't have to rewrite the text. It is a live count that will always update on your site.
I have a question here, Thomas. Yes. Is it possible with the new count function to kind of like filter the count list that you have? For example, can it filter out and count specific visibility states? Or like to even like a specific layer perhaps or something like that?
Yeah, so here you can filter also, and they are now on the same layer. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but here you have different filter functionality, layer, scale, mirror state. Yeah, and it also shows you here on which layer they are and what the scale is. Yeah, if they would be on a different scale, there would be a second row with a different scale. Yeah, this is how you can filter them on top.
I see. Yeah? Okay.
Okay. And this functionality with the count is not only available in model space, it's also available in paper space. Yeah. It would be a little bit boring to show you the same thing now in paper space. And this is why in paper space, I would like to show you something different. So in model space, we just inserted one field. What we want to do right now is we want to insert a whole table. Yeah. Because I can select anything that is connected to a computer, for example, the chair, the computer, the desk, the phone, the IB mat, and the keyboard. And I want it to be involved in my standard layout. I make a little bit space, you know, on the right side. And when I press insert, all these objects will be included. Yeah, they're a little bit big now, but that's not a problem for us. I will just scale them down. Insertion point here. Yeah, and we see here now there's a live count. Yeah, we can rewrite it. I can say not FN phone, just phone, for example. It has no effect. And if I go ahead now, we have 54 phones here. I go ahead and delete these three. We should end up with 51. And that's exactly what's written here. Yeah, so count comes with a lot of functionalities, not only with the numbering, not only with a list of elements of blocks that you have in your drawings, also troubleshoot real issues in your drawing. Okay. Now we go back to model space. And I would like to show you the share functionality. Collaboration, especially in the last year, became part of our digital workflows, collaboration workflows on distributed teams. As I said before, sharing was mainly done with attaching to emails. And now we have the share functionality, which gives us real control over the drawing. We can share with the share button here. We can enter share in the command line, or we could go to the collaborate tab and say, okay, we want to share the drawing. A window open, and in this window, we can choose if we want the viewer to view only, or if he's able, we want him to be able to edit the drawing. So I will do both. I will copy the link, open my browser, and paste the view link inside. Then I go ahead, select edit and save a copy, copy the link, open my browser again. And here we should expect soon the edit tab, the drawing in an editable state. Yeah, it will open now in the web app. We will see the graphical user interface of the web app, but all the edit functionalities, they are grayed out. You see, we have everything. We have the layers, we have the blocks, we have the xrefs, we have the drawing functionalities here. But when we hover over them, it says editing not available. Yeah, we can measure, but everything that comes to or comes together with changing the drawing, yeah, is grayed out. That is different when we go to this link. Yeah, this has edit functionalities. And here we can do everything. We can create a circle. Yeah, everything that is normal, what we can do within the web app. And remember, the links, they are just available for 7 days. So you are in full control of your drawing. And that brings me now, sorry. That brings me now to the next function, and that is the trace functionality. Yeah, as I mentioned before, trace is a collaboration tool that is meant to provide feedback, comments, markups on a drawing without actually changing the content of the drawing. Now think of it as an XREF, yeah, a very lightweight trace paper that is separated from your main drawing and that is put on your drawing. And except of making changes to the drawing itself, you are drawing something on that very thin trace paper. And you find it here, traces. Yeah, there is no trace currently in that drawing, but of course we have edit rights. We can create a new trace. So also the person that gets a valid link for 7 days and has the rights to edit can add a new trace. And that's what I'm going to do. I add a new trace. What I can do is I can draw on the standard layer. Or I create for my trace a new trace layer that is only connected to my traces. That means when the traces are closed, the trace layer will not be visible. But now it allows me to influence also the coloring a little bit. So I will create a new layer that I will mention or name trace new. And it becomes the number green for new. Okay, we go back to the traces. And right now I select the trace new. I go ahead and say, okay, what do we do here? We want to add something, okay? Maybe we add a block. What do we have here in the room from Esther Peters? We don't have a chair. We only have a computer. She doesn't want to sit on the floor. This is why she definitely needs a chair. Yeah, and on top, we would like to add a comment. So this is why use this functionality here and say, Esther needs a chair. Leather, please.
It's good taste on Esther, yeah.
Okay, and that's what the trace contains now. Yeah, and we can close it. Yeah, the whole thing disappears. The layer is not listed anymore here in our layers because it's only connected to the trace. And when we go ahead now and save it, now we say save as. I know I have the same drawing open in my AutoCAD application. This is why I would save it now as a new one, say trace actually. Okay, and I will go back to my a message, the file name. Okay, cancel. I will save it as trace two. Trace two. And now I open it in my AutoCAD application. I go here to open from web and mobile to have access to the drawings that are saved in the cloud. Trace two, open it. And on the first, we don't see anything. Yeah, it looks normal because everything is separated. We say the trace paper is separated from the drawing itself. Yeah, but here in the lower right corner, we see an icon that says traces. And this only appears when there are traces in that drawing. Yeah? If another person like Adam would have created that trace, there would even be a bubble that says, hey, Thomas, there are traces in the drawing, new traces in that drawing. But since I created myself, AutoCAD thinks I'm smart enough to remember that. And this is why this notification doesn't show up. But when we select traces, we see the selected traces. We can open them and we can act accordingly. We can add the seat, the chair to the room from Esther Peters. And then depending on our workflow, say we want to delete it, the trace, we might want to rename it to done trace, for example. Yeah, and then this is covered from our side.
So to clarify, Thomas, are we adding a layer to the model space here with those traces, or are these like comments that we could look at, add that manually ourselves, and then finish the trace like you did there?
Yeah, if you want to imagine it with a picture, let's say we have this drawing floor plan sample, and you need to imagine something that is like an XREF.
Right.
Yeah, there's an XREF on top of this drawing that only contains the traces. Yeah. So you really have to separate it in your imagination. They are separated from each other. One drawing that is just something like reference to it. It contains the traces, and the other drawing only has the content of that drawing inside. And it's also important to know you can save the drawing files until version 2010, then it will be kept within that drawing. But if you save it further down, you will lose the trace. Same with the DXF file. When you save it as a DXF file, the traces will be lost. But remember, you can only view the traces in the 22 version.
I see.
Yeah? Did that make sense, Adam?
Right. Okay. Yeah. So it's still compatible with old versions, and there's still the references like an XREF more so than the model space that we're adding geometry to.
Yeah. So the layers, if I would go to the layers now, there is no
trace XREF.
Trace layer because it's separated. It's not within.
Interesting. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. We showed you a way to do collaboration with a share command. Where you forward PDF files, drawing files. But now I would like to show you a way to forward PDF files. Yeah, that is actually push to docs, which was introduced with the AU last year. And you see the functionality here. With push to Autodesk docs, you have a function that pushes a file, a drawing file directly to Autodesk Docs, and it's pushed out as a PDF file. And that means you no longer have to save the PDF locally, open the web browser, and upload the sheets to the cloud. So instead of taking several steps, you only have to take one step. And that's what we are doing right now. I say push to Autodesk Docs, and now you can select not only the sheets that are within your drawing, you can navigate to other drawings and add them too. And then you have a list of sheets that you can summarize, publish to a folder within Autodesk Docs. Yeah. You can also, once you have this list of maybe 20 sheets that you want to publish every Monday morning, you can save it. Yeah, put it on your desktop, for example. And then every Monday morning, you can load that list and upload the sheets. So you don't even have to redo the list every time. You can really load it and then upload the sheets based on the new changes of the drawing underneath. Yeah, so we press upload sheets. And then we can select a folder. Yeah, for example, ECW in my project Ingolstadt. We say okay. And now it will start being uploaded. So I will open the browser to view the uploaded documents in Autodesk Docs. And it might take a while, depending on my internet speed, since I had to switch off my video. So this might affect the situation here currently too. Let's see, here they are arriving. Yeah, they are uploading automatically. You can open them here. You can use the functionality that comes with the platform. Yeah, revision clouds, add text, and so on. And even if you have different versions, let's say version one, version two, you can compare them with each other and see the changes really within that router. Okay. Yeah, I think that was the overview of the new functions that come with version 22. Yeah, from my side, I think I covered everything here right now. So I'm very happy to move forward to the Q&A part. I'm sure Adam already answered some questions in the background, but in case there are still some open questions, please feel free.
Absolutely, yeah. Thanks, Thomas. I tried to sneak some of them in there as you were presenting. So we got a few here. I got one from Weber here. They're talking about Autodesk Docs because Autodesk Docs is one of the benefits, subscription benefits of the AEC collection, correct?
Yeah.
And if I have standalone AutoCAD, do I get access to Autodesk Docs still if I just have regular AutoCAD subscription or no?
You have access to the functionality within the AutoCAD application, but you are not able to push them to Autodesk Docs because you need a subscription.
I see. Right. Is that the same for the product design collection too, with the Autodesk Docs, availability?
I think it's only available for the AEC collection.
Oh, interesting. Okay. Right on. Thank you. Let's see. And to clarify again on the trace, so if someone makes a trace, we cannot push it into like a model space layer. There's no way to push it into a layer specifically for model space, just to clarify.
What I did, well, let me summarize. When I started, the standard layer when I wanted to create a new trace was 0.
Right.
So if I would have created something, it would have been by default on the layer 0, which was white at that time. I could have done that, mm-hmm. but when you open the drawing, it is drawn on the same layer, but it is not part of the drawing. So in order to see it, you really need to select the trace in version 22 to see it. Yeah. Otherwise, the other option is just to do it the old school way before 22, to mix the trace objects together with other objects in the same drawing.
Yeah, because it gets identified and flagged in like the trace, yes. Notification in AutoCAD, right? So it's not really pushing into a layer. We still have to make the changes on the model space if we do need to add changes. Is that right?
Yeah. So you need to create a trace. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter on which layer it is, but that object is only visible when you see the trace list. And if you would create a trace on a new layer, that new layer would not be listed in model space except when you have the trace list open.
Right, because it's not like a model space layer. It's just like a specific trace object that doesn't participate, right?
Yeah.
And if I want to make those changes, you inserted a chair block, for example, mm-hmm. do I have to then insert a chair block myself onto a regular model space layer outside of the trace environment, even though I've approved it?
So when you create a trace, I'm not sure if I understood correctly, but when you create a trace, you can use the existing layer structure, and put it on the same layer on one of the existing layers, but it is literally not in the same drawing. Yeah, it's like in a separated drawing that actually copies the layer structure of the original drawing.
Right. I got you. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Let's see what other questions we got here. Now, when you're sharing a drawing, can you set the date to have the link expire? I guess Yeah. Can you set like timeouts on the links that you send out? Is that right?
I understood the 7 days as a default. Mm-hmm. Let me just have a closer look. Yeah, so we run the trace. Sorry, it was not the trace, it was a share. We run the share command. And I don't see any configuration here. Yeah. So currently I'm not aware of here it says. And this feels like hard coded. Do you see the second line in the window?
Yeah.
Link expires in 7 days.
I see. Yeah. That seems to be hard coded. I don't see any additional configuration. Right on. Okay, cool. I'll take that. And I know Thomas Riley was also posting in chat as well. He's having some trouble with the count function. He was getting an error. The current selection does not contain any supported object for counting. It'll still produce the count list, but it won't do the highlights. Are there any like particular requirements or configurations for the blocks that would help them be counted properly? Is there anything to be aware of in that regard?
Yeah, I would recommend in general, because I'm not sure how it behaves with proxy objects.
Yeah, I see.
To have proxy notice set to 1, to be aware if the drawing that we are currently talking about has proxy objects included, because I'm not sure if they can be counted properly. Yeah, because also proxy objects can be within blocks, and I'm not sure if that works with all proxy objects or in general properly with the proxy object.
I see. Yeah, so there might be more to that question, unfortunately, Thomas. But proxy objects can be definitely part of that. So what else we could answer here? We're coming up on time pretty shortly. I think I'm going to take one more question here. Let's see. Can you bring the Revit linked AutoCAD model to assemble systems to be able to see metadata, or do we need to redraw AutoCAD to Revit to see the metadata? I'm not sure if we could answer that here on this call, actually.
Yeah. I would suggest for this question then the way with customer support is the more reliable one, because then also the colleagues from Revit can be included, and I think that's better.
I see. And then I guess this one too as well. When pushing drawings to PDF, can you, I'm sorry, I'm not sure if this is related to the push to Autodesk function, John, but when pushing drawings to PDF, can you control color to grayscale? In general for publishing, yeah, you have control over the color options, I believe. I'm not sure if that's exactly what you're asking for, John.
Yeah, I think I understand.
Under so, Autodesk docs, yeah.
Yeah, I think right now I selected the wrong thing. So I think he's asking for push to docs, yeah, and which options you have here. If you can, for example, say here, okay, I want just this be printed to grayscale. Yeah. I think this is connected to the sheet set or to the sheet set manager, right, or in general, right, to the way the page setup is done for that layer. So my first way here would be to do the configuration in the page setup manager, save the drawing, and then check how it behaves when you push the drawings out.
Right. Okay. That sounds good. And then I guess one last thing here from Brandon Weiss. Can a read-only drawing be copied into a new drawing? I think in general, I think that's still okay, because you could still open the read-only drawings, right? And you could still control all and so, control V if you want to.
I'm trying to select here, which is not, wait, is it? Yeah, it is possible. I can select. Wait, why is it? Okay. So within the drawing, it works. Yeah. And when we say, okay, we want to create a new drawing. Let's give it a little bit. You can still see my screen, right?
Correct. Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Let me take this one then. Here, I don't. It doesn't take my clipboard content, so it can't be copied to another drawing.
I see. Yeah. I see. Yeah, because it's all locked into the web portal essentially, right? Yeah. I get. That's interesting. Okay, that's perfect. Yeah,
and also here, I'm currently in the blocks section. Yeah. There's also no context to insert blocks. So
I see.
Not supported.
Right on. Okay. I think that's the last question we could take here. We're at the hour here right now. So I think that'll about do it for us here today, Thomas. Do you have any other closing slides you want to put up really quick?
No, the Q&A was more or less, my last one.
Yeah. That's fantastic. Right on.
So,
okay.
So in general, take your time to look at all the new features and the enhancements. Mm-hmm. Just take everything. Use the collaboration functions that you have. Yeah, to push you and to push the work with your colleagues a little bit further and to work smarter. This in general, don't stick to old behavior. Just try to see how the new functionalities work for you. That's what I would like to add.
Fantastic, dude. Yeah, thanks again for coming by, Thomas. You're a real trooper. I know it's late over there. Now you might not have been feeling the best this week, but we appreciate your time. And hope to talk to you again soon. Okay.
Yeah, no, thanks a lot for the invitation. Sorry for my cough. It was actually not my choice. Worries. I would like to avoid it.
That's but okay.
It was not too bad. Okay.
That's no great. Problem. Yeah. Thank you, Thomas. Thank you, audience members. You'll be receiving an email with some survey responses as well if you want to provide any feedback from us at Kativ. Otherwise, have a good rest of the week, and we'll catch you next week for What's New in Inventor 2022. Bye, everybody.